Assalamu alaikum. I hope all students will be fine. Dear students, I am your maths teacher with our fifth lesson of mathematics of unit number 6. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Here are the objectives of today's lesson. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to understand direct proportion and solve word problems of exercise number 3. Here is our today's topic, ratio and proportion, in which we are going to discuss introduction to direct proportion and will solve exercise number 3 on page number 92. Material required for today's lesson is lead pencil, eraser, highlighter, mathematics book, notebook, black pointer, blue pen, and ruler. I hope you all are having this material with you. Let's take a recap of our previous lesson in which we have done ratio and proportion exercise number 2 part C till F of unit number 6. Dear students, let's start our today's topic that is direct proportion on page number 91. Two quantities are said to be directly proportional if an increase in one results in an increase in the other, or a decrease in one results in decrease in the other. दो quantities को directly proportional कहा जाता है अगर एक quantity के बढ़ जाने से दूसरी quantity भी बढ़ जाए, या एक quantity के कम हो जाने से दूसरी quantity भी कम हो जाए तो. Dear students, we have an example on page number 91. If 5 kg of rice cost rupees 225, how much will 8 kg of rice cost? Cost of 5 kg of rice equals to rupees 225. More quantity costs more. It means when you are increasing the quantity of something, obviously the price of that thing will also be increased. Cost of 1 kg of rice equals to rupees 225 divided by 5. My dear students, to find out the cost of 8 kg, first of all, you have to find out the cost of 1 kg. And to find out the cost of 1 kg, you will divide the given price of 225 over 5. That is equals to rupees 45. Now, cost of 8 kg equals to rupees 45 multiplied by 8. You will multiply rupees 45 by 8. And that is equals to rupees 360. So, the cost of 8 kg of rice is rupees 360. Dear students, as you know that we always start writing our notebook work by writing first the index page. You can see the index page here. So, let's start writing your today's index. That is serial number 5, date, topic, that is unit number 6, ratio and proportion. Exercise number 3, part A till D. Let's start our notebook work. Before starting our notebook work, let me tell you how to prepare the notebook page. Date, today's task, topic, ratio and proportion. Exercise number 3, page number 91, part A. If 8 oranges cost rupees 96, what will the cost of 14 oranges? So let's start writing the solution. Cost of 8 oranges equals to rupees 96. Cost of 1 orange equals to 96 over 8. Dear students, to find out the price of 14 oranges, first you have to find out the price of 1 orange. So, to find out the price of 1 orange, you will divide the given price over 8. 96 divided by 8 and it is equals to rupees 12. Now, cost of 14 oranges equals to rupees 12 multiplied by 14. And the answer is rupees 168. So, in this way, we found the price of 14 oranges. We have part B. If 18 dolls cost rupees 630, how many dolls can be bought for rupees 455? So let's start writing the solution. Cost of 18 dolls equals to rupees 630. Cost of 1 doll equals to rupees 630 divided by 18.
Dear students, to know that how many dolls can be bought for rupees 455, first of all you have to find out the cost of one doll. And to find out the cost of one doll, you will divide 630 over 18. So we are going to divide 630 over 18 by cutting method. 3 6s are 18, 3 2s are 6, 3 1s are 3 and 3 0s are 0. 2 10 over 6. Let's divide again on the table of 6. 6 1s are 6, 6 3s are 18, 3 with 0 now it becomes 30. 6 5s are 30. That is equal to rupees 35. Cost of one doll is equal to rupees 35. Now, dolls bought in rupees 455 equals to 455 divided by 35. We are going to divide 455 over 35 by cutting method. 5 7s are 35, 5 9s are 45 and 5 1s are 5. 91 over 7. Let's divide again. 7 1s are 7. 7 1s are 7. 2 with 1, 21. 7 3s are 21. And the answer is 13 dolls. 13 dolls can be bought for rupees 455. We have part C. If a man earns rupees 8,050 per week, in how many days he will earn rupees 13,800? Dear students, per week means 1 week. So let's start writing the solution. Earning of 7 days or 1 week equals to rupees 8,050. Earning of 1 day equals to rupees 8,050 divided by 7. Dear students, to know that in how many days he can earn rupees 13,800, first of all, you have to find out the earning of 1 day. And to find out the earning of 1 day, you will divide 8,050 over 7. So I'm going to divide these two values by cutting method. 7 1s are 7. 7 1s are 7, 7 1s are 7, 7 5s are 35, and 7 0s are 0. So now, earning of 1 day equals to rupees 1,150. Now, he can earn rupees 13,800 equals to rupees 13,800 divided by 1,150. I'm going to divide these two values again by cutting method. That is equal to 1380 over 115. So I divided it on the table of 10. Next, I will divide it by the table of 5 and we'll get 276 over 23. Now you know that number 23 is a prime number. So we will divide it last time on the table of 23 and we'll get the answer 12 over 1. So now he can earn rupees 13,800 equals to 12 days. In 12 days, he can earn rupees 13,800. We have our last part, part B. If a car covers 96 kilometers in 12 liters of petrol, how much distance will it cover in 24 liters of petrol? So let's start writing the solution. Distance covered in 12 liters equals to 96 kilometers. Distance covered in 1 liter. To find out the distance in 24 liters, first you have to find out the distance covered in 1 liter. So you will divide 96 over 12. 96 divided by 12 and you will get the answer 8 kilometers. So now you can find the distance Covered in 24 liters equals to 8 kilometers multiplied by 24, and our answer is 192 kilometers. Dear students, I hope you understood very well from our today's lesson. Dear students, as you know, we have highlighted some points and have solved exercise number 3. Now it's time to assess yourself. So let's start filling these blanks. There are dash types of proportion. Two quantities are said to be dash if any increase in one results in an increase in the other, or a decrease in one results in a decrease in the other. Let's take a quick review of today's lesson. We have done introduction to direct proportion and have solved exercise number 3, part A till D. Of page number 92.
In next lesson, we will discuss about unit number 6, inverse proportion, and we'll solve exercise number 5, part ATD of page number 93.
Task to do. Learn the highlighted points and definitions.
Solve exercise number 3 of page number 92, part CTF.
Learn the tables of 10 and 11
and do their dodging. And don't forget to practice this exercise on register again and again.
Dear students, I hope you have learned so much from our today's lesson.
Don't forget to practice this exercise on your register.
Take good care of yourself.
Allah Hafiz.